Welcome to another exciting episode of Fishing with Jay. Mr. Court just showed up. Holy smokes, boy.
What's up, Bubba?
Oh, man.
Did you do this yourself?
One of my dearest friends of all time, Court, made it out all the way from his troubled home waters, the Tampa Bay. Going through some real serious situations right now.
Drove over last night, got here like midnight.
I'm sweating, it's hot, but so worth it to go on some flats with these boys and catch my first snook on a fly. Don't cross our path, cause you're gonna get stopped.
We ain't gonna give anybody any slack.
You know, some of the most special people I've ever met have just been through the fly fishing community on random, you know, like being a fisherman in general, you know that person's pretty weird right off the bat, but also probably pretty cool. Nobody fishes to have a bad time. You're shooting pretty well on that because it's not something you do to get angry at or, you know, take too serious.
Sometimes people wonder how we hang. Well, it's pretty tough.
It's tough. Every time.
Snook on a fly.
I've heard lore of these. I've never seen one. I don't even know what they look like besides on photographs and videos, but that also could be, you know, make-believe too.
Our only form of defense in this situation is gonna be a fly rod. But we're prepared to defend the boat and our people and our pride from the dangerous fish that live in this lagoon. Like a kitten, like a kitty cat. You see that?
Floating, baby.
There's a lot of confidence in the boat. I'm ready to go.
I love the deck.
Yeah.
Came out really, really good.
So when you're casting, rocking, doesn't make the fly go any further. But what does is sound effects, like. Oh, 10 feet more. I need to get more line out.
Whoa!
Woo!
This is Casey Anderson reporting day 1,348. Many moons since I've seen a fish. But it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen right now, today. It's been really tough, so we had to pull out Court and Jay to make this happen.
I hear it's good luck if you can get a dolphin to eat a fly.
They say it tastes like a cross between bald eagle and bull trout.
I think that's the taste of liberty.
Freedom.
Still heard lore, still haven't seen one, still don't know if they exist or what this is about. Everybody talks about them. I don't know.
Make a couple of casts right out there, Karen.
Oh, that's a tarpon! Ah! That was a little baby tarpon.
We have a tarpon wizard here. Old Court and the saltwater specialists. Court does all the rad stuff. He's in a real bind right now, though, because of the red tide has killed a ton of fish in his homeland.
The nice thing about Tampa, though, we have a lot of options, so we should be able to get around it, at least work around it somewhat.
This is not a forever thing.
I think that Mother Nature will fix herself. Every area, no matter where you come from, they have some kind of environmental situation that's just not being handled like everybody knows it should be.
Is that a tail at 12 o'clock, Casey? Like almost to the sandbar?
Yep, right there, bang it.
The old 16 pound test, killing it. Oh, I broke off on probably a good snook that's still swimming around and real angry back there.
Took me a while to get warmed up, you know, on that one.
Ah, the learning curve.
learning curve of sometimes, and a lot of, actually more often than not, the learning curve of humility.
Oh, we got a fucking knot, goddamn it.
Something's that awesome, it's gonna get really tough. There's a big balance of all that. It's as cool as and kick-ass as things are, there's gonna be a lot of shitty stuff that goes down. Trout don't move that fast where I'm from.
Yeah, probably some of the biggest trout in the world on average. Pyramid Lake's a very special place for the soul and any trout fisherman out there, 100%. Went there as a little kid, born and raised in Reno and Sparks. Once I found fly fishing, I pretty much just lived there in a tent for years. I really kind of got it dialed pretty well out there, so guiding was kind of, I think, the next step. Plus, I love to show what fly fishing did for me.
What would you do if you were king of the world?
If I was king of the world, there's a lot of better things we can do with what's going on and the money being pushed around and people's decisions. I think if I was king of the world, I would try to act on some of that, some future stuff instead of thinking about the pocket at the time. Whatever that may be, environmentally, humanity, anything, I think that's the push. I'd also still tattoo and I would still fly fish, 100%. Maybe even more. I would definitely tattoo for free.
That way.
Leonida, Leonida!
Smells that one? Is it a better one than the other day?
Ooh. Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh. Fucking stop him. Stop him, boy.
He's wrapped.
Uh-oh, shit.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah. That was cool.
Yeah. Oh, you're railroading me in the mangrove, baby.
Just got work. You just went to school, kid. You just went to school for real. That was like, you were sissyfooting and sissyfooting. And then it was like, oh, I would like to party now.
That's truth. That's the truth. That's the truth.
That was awesome.
We just touched a sacred beetle. The beetle of metamorphosis is going to change the world today.
Hi, Mom.
First deck.
Man, they're like bulldogs. Look at them teeth. That's crazy.
Crazy.
They're angry and they're hungry and they're mean and they're tough.
Oh, that's a tarpon! That's in the water! Oh, tarpon!
That's a real tarpon. They're real. They're real. Is it? No, it's a lady fish.
Or how you catch fish when you're sitting.
Catch them on
Boys.
The angle.
Dude, these fish are so savage. I was just about to start talking about being a trout guide in the snook bit. Woo! My man.
There you go, let him go.
Yeah. This is definitely a little bit more hard-earned than some of the other fish that I'm used to. That's for sure. Man, they're so cool. Built for killing. It happened! There's fish here. There's fish around, and they eat flies. And it's real, and it's a real thing. A lot of fails before success. That's for sure. But that's kind of like anything, you know? Thank you, boys. Dude.
Yeah.
Phew.
Thanks to Court, I caught my first snook.
Casey, I got to go on vacation.
Feels like a ponga.
Dries like a ponga.
That was a nice ponga ride.
Monumentous. The boat has landed its first fish, and it's a snook. Couldn't wish for a better situation.
No. I found out snook are real, though. It's day 1,300, whatever it is. Signing out.